name's Faizan Wasserman. I have cerebral palsy and bilateral periventricular leukomalacia, which affects my balance. And I'm 12 and a half years old. My dad has always said to me, I can do anything I want to, I just have to put my mind to it.
Faizan was born 3 months premature. And when he was about 6 months old, we were told that he was going to have problems, and we didn't know what. So after seeing all the specialists, we were told he had cerebral palsy. But we didn't know to what extent.
Well, I'm Barbara Newman, so I'll be 90 in a couple of months, which I'm very proud of. I really got travelling because my uncle lived in America, my mother's brother, and I was supposed to go there for the evacuation. And then a boat was sunk and a lot of children were lost. And I got myself an immigration visa and I finally got over there in 1947 when I was 18. It was great. And then my uncle said to me, well, you know, you can't stay here forever unless you do something. What do you want to do with your life? So I said, well, I suppose I could go to university. So my uncle said, well, he said, why don't you try nursing? They'll take anybody in nursing. I thought, oh, I'll show him. So I went to the local hospital in New Jersey and asked to come into the September class, because it was June, July time by this time. And the matron said to me, she said, I'm ever so sorry. She said, I can't accept you. She said, your qualifications are brilliant. She said, your education level, but she said, you have to have American history and problems of American democracy. I said, why do I have to give them the Gettysburg Address in their deathbeds? She said, don't be rude and don't be cheeky. So I said, right, I'll go and do my midwifery. So I came back into Ilford, where my parents live, and I did my midwifery. And then I went into the East End of London, Leytonstone, and I called the midwife. I was delivering babies just like them.
We don't tell him he's disabled. There was one day he came back from school and said to me, he said, Dad, he said, am I disabled? I said, Faizan, I said, can you walk? He said, yes. So you just do a little bit different, don't you? He said, yeah. I said, you're differently abled. You know, he's done more than the average kid in his school's done. He's got the confidence to do things.
Things I have done, I've been around in any car you can imagine. Met Lewis Hamilton, Nick Hamilton, who is Lewis Hamilton's brother who has cerebral palsy. I'm going to meet Anthony Joshua sometime soon. I've met the whole of the West Ham team. I've been to multiple football matches. I've been to Paralympics. I've met a Paralympian called Anwar Fula, and I've done many, many more things.
I was asked to join St John Ambulance as a sister in the Romford division to teach the kids first aid and cadets, the first aid and home nursing, which I did. I was asked, would I be interested in doing air wing? Which I said, well, what does that consist of? He said, well, people have taken ill abroad if they come from England. The aeroplanes won't bring them back unless they have an escort. And so it went on from there. And then I got a letter, which, as I say, is framed in my hallway, that said to me, thank you very much for your 100th mission. The air wing really put a lot of pins in the map. 65 countries I counted. I had a layover in an airport and I thought, what can I do with myself? And I started to put down all the places that I'd been. And then I had my map here at home when I came home and ratified what I'd remembered and what I'd put on my map and added a few more.
It was a few years ago, a friend of mine just rang me up and said, we need some help. I said, what's the matter? He said, we're doing a fashion show for children in need and we need somebody to build the catwalk. So I rang my wife and said, look, you and Faizan get ready. I said, you're coming to a fashion show. So they came. And then when we were there, Faizan was sitting at the front and said to me, I want to walk down that catwalk. I said, okay, leave it with me. So I spoke to one of the models and sure enough, she went walking down a catwalk with him. He loves all of the attention and as you can see, he's very confident in what he does.
You know you've got this ability to help and perhaps sort things out. I said that to my daughter one day. I said, you know what? I said, I feel that I've been sent sometimes to some of these places and meet some of the people that I've been with, because I said, we've made some, improvements in their lives and got some help that they needed, and which is a gift, I suppose. I've enjoyed it. Got lots of happy memories.
I'm proud of Faizan to be able to do the things that he does and to be able to get this award. And I'd just like to thank everybody that's nominated Faizan.
Scrap what you think you can't do, turn it into positive energy and believe in yourself.
I'm very sorry I can't be with you today. Unfortunately, I had previously booked a holiday before I knew I was going to get this magnificent award, which I'm very proud of and very grateful. And thank you very much. I've enjoyed living in Ilford, and thank you for this award, which I'm very grateful.